Yeah, no doubt about it, Sampley. How you doing today?
Oh, boy, got hay to mow there. Finished it up. Took me 2.5 hours to mow today. I'm going to take 40 minutes. It took me 2.5 hours. Man, it was a mess, but I got it cleaned up for
him. Now, that's not the one you did for the girl. That's somebody else?
For the girl. Down the over, next block over, west of it.
Oh, 10-4. Hell, I thought you already said you did that one.
I mowed the front yesterday. Anyway, I worked that down my hour, hour and a half, weed eating and doing around the swimming pool.
Yeah, that's right, the swimming pool.
I done the swimming pool today.
Did you go swimming?
Yeah, well, no, well, I'll say it this way, it's sort of green color.
Oh, man, you said the swimming pool looked good.
No, I said it looks good from the road. Goddamn, get in there and look in it.
10-4.
Skeeter better take some medication with it if they're gonna dot in there.
He needs to take some medication?
That mosquito better take some medication with it if it's gonna go swimming in that pool.
Damn, that must be pretty bad.
You know what chlorine and bleach is? He said, yeah, we run out of money. I said, well, damn, somebody donate a little bit to clean that damn and set the place up. He looked at me and started laughing.
Yeah, 10-4 needs some shock. That's what they need, shock.
Well, bleach and Clorox will do the same thing for a while.
Yeah, well, if they get some pure chlorine, maybe.
Yeah, well, hey, it works. I've used it before. Before they made the shock stuff, they had the bleach and chlorine.
It's not a kiddie pool, is it?
Hell no, it's a big old pool.
Above ground or in ground?
Figure my damn patio room back here in the back. Below ground.
Damn, poor.
That was placed 2 years ago.
They keep it pumping?
I said, they don't want to drive, huh?
They keep it pumping?
He says, she says you're working in Mobile. And I said, they don't want to drive, huh? You drive out every damn morning. She said, yeah, sometime I pulled over, she'll say, all right, damn.
Bowling Green ain't that far away. It's just in Hardy County.
I know where it's at. It's a hell of a drive. You got to drive it every day and then pull it over, she'll get tired when you get off.
Do they keep the pump running?
No.
Well, if they don't keep the pump running, they ain't gonna keep crap going on.
Tell me about it. I just told him to get some damn chlorine pour on it. Pour about 4 gallon in there and watch it. I said, it'll clear it up, but you ain't gotta worry about eating the plastic up, have you? And he just laughed. Run out of money. I said, well, everybody's out of money every now and then. Damn, you donate a little bit to the pool.
Yeah, pools are money pit.
That thing of it is dog shit all the way around it.
Ew.
Hey, what I said, I tiptoed through that grass.
Your poor mower.
No, we're down here.
Ew. Hopefully you didn't hit any fresh patties.
Well, there's all kind of that, like I said, I was tiptoeing. You didn't have no trouble smelling that for you when you got in there.
Yeah, that dog crap has a unique smell.
Ew. Bam. So how's everything going, job, Jay? Pretty good?
Can't complain, Sampley. Can't complain. All positive work.
Pretty good. I want to come out good today.
Every once in a while you get a day like that.
Waiting that weather.
Beautiful weather.
Yeah, you don't have to worry about sweating too much, do you?
No, it's nice. I like 80 degrees. Perfect.
Like about 75, 80. Too cold, ain't too hot. You can get out there and work a little bit. Don't have to worry about wiping all that sweat.
410.
You've been drinking and smoking too damn much, and you sweat all the time when you do that shit.
smoking.
Damn dope, what you think? Damn bunch of them smokes that shit, boy. You know that shit on TV, when they go Orlando in court right now, banning that medication marijuana, boy, that's gonna be a good one.
Yeah, it is. I don't understand how they gonna ban it. They pass the law.
They reversing the law, so they said. That's why I was watching TV when I turned this on. And they said, they over there banning it. Going to, having a hearing right now on banning it. Statewide.
Well, the people said yes, so good luck with that.
Well, it's up to the court system. It ain't panning out like it's supposed to. Too many damn faults. Too many defects.
Yeah.
Back to the suppliers, what you call it, druggist, the stores. Why just call a little bit of it?
The pharmacist?
Yeah, going at the pharmacist. Let me tell her all that shit illegal, huh?
Well, they don't have nothing crazy going on yet, it's just oils and stuff.
Well, I ain't going up there to the damn field up there, I don't know where the garden is at, and you know, you won't freeze, you know, you don't get caught them throwing it over the fence.
They got a field? Where's that at?
Like Wales.
They do?
Oh, yeah, they got all kinds of fields around up in yonder, boy. Ain't you been keeping up with the news?
I guess not. Has Grady Judd got a handle on it?
I don't know what Grady Judd does, but I tell you what, they sure as hell go on it up there, for I know several people works up there.
410.
Don't leave me out of all them discounts.
I want to know where they're throwing that 420 over the fence. I'm going to have to pull up there and give me a little bit of that.
I mean, like, well, out there outside of Mustang way down on out there. You ain't heard about that grow field up there?
No, apparently not. Yeah, I don't know about that stuff. I don't keep up with that.
Yeah, I keep up with that busting up for their asses.
Yeah, 10-4. Well, if I was the police like you were, I'd probably be keeping up with it, too.
You tell them, hey, could bring me some of them, see if it's worthy of smoking. I don't smoke that shit. They're stupid enough to bring me some.
I don't want to smoke it, I want to smell it. I want to see what it smells like.
But is that good weed? Sure as hell smell it if it's around.
It smell like a skunk?
Oh, it smells good.
Oh, I want it to smell like a skunk.
I smoked that shit back in the 70s, back in the 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78. Oh, did I smoke some good ass weed. I could poke a gold, that was some of the best you could get. I had to hit a nigga snake, just drive and keep my mouth shut and shoot the motherfucker if he opened his mouth up.
Wow.
They shut up, they'll come out here and arrest me again.
They can't arrest the police.
You know damn police. 70 back in the 70s.
You were a deputy back in the 70s?
A junior deputy, a trainee, getting my training on the field, out in the field. Bust your own mama, bust your own dad. You see, you drink a beer, I'm supposed to turn your ass in, call you in.
Oh yeah, 10-4. You got a light out on the front of your car, if you found a cop car with a light out, that was good.
Well yeah, you see them wandering down the street, you see them get out and take a piss on the side of the street, call them in.
Whoop whoop.
Ooh. Hey, they train you to do that shit too. They do it in the army too.
They were training you to be a snitch.
Well, they trained me to be a federal, and my brother was a MP in the Army for, MP, police in the Army for 17 years, what do you think about that? He comes visit me all the time. He looks at my boy, he says, boy, that goes a crook right there. He spot them suckers a mile away.
10-4.
Hey, talking about some scam bags in this neighborhood right here today, talking about the scamming going on. They'll come promise this, promise that, saying doing this, doing that, they ain't doing nothing but scamming your ass. And going to church and doing it too. Now that's a good ass Christian.
10-4, how's the drug war going on in your neighborhood?
I don't know. It's still the cops getting them every night around here.
10-4, so they're doing their job. You helping them out any?
Okay.
Are you helping them out any?
I ain't gonna comment on that one.
Come on, Sam, please get you in an interview.
All you gotta do is listen to me talk on CB. They listen to us on CB, no bullshit.
10-4, we ain't sitting here talking about doing drugs in your neighborhood, though.
Well, there's a bunch of them going on in the neighborhood. Don't face the rest of our pocket.
I didn't say there wasn't. I'm just saying we're not on the CB talking about what's going on in your neighborhood.
Well, I'm talking about our neighborhood.
Okay.
We have two meth labs, meth houses. So, hell, I don't know how much you got, but I told her 2 weeks before she got busted out there, honey. Said, car sitting down here, they're gonna bust your ass. Who is that? I've been sitting down there the last couple days, coming sitting like an hour at a time. They must be trying to find their way. They must be lost. I said, let me ride down there and see. Pulled up. They're taking pictures up one side down, and they asked me, what the hell are you doing down there? I said, I went tell her y'all gonna bust her ass. You better not her. I said, nah, I didn't tell her. They got her about a week later.
10-4, doesn't sound like she was a real smart lady.
Was it? And her husband, he got 5 damn years 2 months earlier. I told his ass too, he didn't listen. Cut it out, boy, cut it out. Oh, go back down to your house. I said, I am going to my house. But damn, man, whoo, you crazy as hell. He said, oh, I don't give a shit. They can't do nothing to me. They got to catch me. I said, really? What are you drinking, boy? Or smoking?
Sprite, smoking is crack.
My old boy down the street down yonder, he did, before he moved here, he got 2 life sentences. That ain't bad, is it?
Goodness gracious.
4 months ago, you're a cop. He got about 10 to 15. That ain't bad, is it? Lives down the street down between me and High Pocket. Not bad if you're a cop. High Pocket got a bunch of that shit going on in his neighborhood over there, too.
Y'all live in the same damn neighborhood.
Hell yeah. He's got it all behind him over there, on the west, back behind him, on the west side, back behind him. Shit, man, it's going on big and hot and heavy over there. I better shut it.
Top of the evening there, Wizard.
Top of the evening, you guys.
Wizard, I hear you down there. You have a good afternoon, too.
I hear you up there. You have a good afternoon, too.
Yeah, we were talking about all the drugs in the neighborhood. I was going to get to the prostitutes next.
Well, I'll tell you what, you know, I was told that there's more drugs around here in Avon Park and Highlands County than I would have never known that.
Yeah, I can come down in your neighborhood and sit down there about 2 or 3 days and I just sit there and point my finger at them. We shit pot full of them down there.
Probably not in my neighborhood.
Uh-huh. Well, you must be living out there about 20 miles from everybody then, huh?
Yeah, pretty much. I don't have any neighbors that I can see.
You go down to Avon Park around 913 in that area in there? When they see me, they run and hide. It's you! Oh, dude, what you doing in here? What you doing down here? I said, I'm down here visiting. Wow, what's up, man?
Oh, boy.
Oh, man,
I got the red light on.
Yeah, I said, no, we under the
bar. No, you did it.
Yeah, 10-4 there, Sam Flea. Well, I don't know, man. They gotta watch out for you. They gotta watch out for that junior deputy coming through.
No damn, Debbie. Andy, I went down there to buy a house down there between you and Wizard back off out there. Towards Avon Park, Sabrina. Looked at the house, they had me over there on $12,000. Moved my ass in. I didn't even got out of the car, walked out in the yard and stuff, got halfway around the house. The woman come running across the street. What in the world? What are you doing? I said, where the hell did you come from? She said, I live right over there. I said, Lord have mercy. And Mike O'Leary said, who in the hell is that? I said, that was somebody that I met a while back. Are you moving in here? I says, well, think about buying. Oh, we're gonna have some parties, ain't we? I said, not me, I ain't.
Now, why would she think that you were gonna have a party with her?
She was married.
Didn't sound like it used to stop you before.
Well, my ex-wife was standing there. I didn't want to get my ass whipped again.
Well, you did say ex-wife.
No, she just talked shit out of her. She liked beating them old men's head then. But if you so fast make your head swim, just pop your jaws to her out of the way. Just pop off to her out of the way and see what she does to you.
Sounds like she's a regular badass.
I tend to take a 240-pound woman and knock her out across down Rickshaw.
How about Polk County finest?
That's no, me and about three nurses and two doctors. That old man.
Imagine that.
He was standing there looking at her beat the hell out of his girlfriend. She said, I'm married to him. What are you doing over there messing around with my husband for? All the men here said you get married. She said, you dumb bitch. I said, I'm his wife. And she just beat the living hell out of her. Snow about half knee deep. You ever seen a snow flying? She was kicking that old girl's ass every time she would wiggle that leg, she'd kick her ass.
Well, that must have made you feel pretty proud to get, you know, she's kicking her ass over you.
Wasn't kicking her ass over me, she's kicking her ass over her first husband.
Oh, her first husband? I thought it was you. Okay, never mind.
Man, her first husband used to party quite a bit, drinking, right up and down the street, you know?
Did she do that for you, too?
Oh, hell yeah. Still come run your ass off if she thinks you're in here doing something you ain't supposed to be doing. She ain't supposed to be 1,000 feet of me. She'll still come in here and tell you to get your ass down the street.
Still keeping them women away from you.
You bullshitting either.
Well, I'm trying to get the whole gist of that story.
Either. I said, you need to go home. She said, I am. So is that bitch leaves.
I'm trying to get the whole gist of that story. Now, your buddy, you took your buddy's wife and married your wife?
Oh, I didn't take his wife. He divorced her and married that bitch, and the bitch got all his money and left his ass sitting. About a year later, I went back, or 2 years later, I went back to Michigan, and I called up, and she said, they got a divorce. I said, I already know what's going on. So I went and seen him and went and seen her, and funny story of her was, I come back to Florida, she showed up here the same damn time I did.
But it was your buddy's wife.
That was his ex-wife then, but she kicked his ass too.
But then it became your wife and she kicked your ass.
Yeah, she beat up on me a couple times. She got a 1,000-foot trespassing warning on her ass. She can beat the hell out of a cop. What you think about that? I could have went to beat the hell out of a cop. Try to beat the hell out of a cop. Finally, knocked her up against the car and told her he gonna break her down next. She didn't quit hitting him.
Man, you must have been one proud man to have a woman like that.
The proud man when I got rid of her, too.
Well, what the hell would ever possess you to get her in the first place?
Thought she was a pretty nice damn woman until I got married to her, found out what she was doing. She didn't smoke, she didn't drink, and she just sat there and said, you better watch what you're doing, I don't like that shit. Your paycheck. I said, I put it up. Where'd you put it? I said, I put it down the door.
You gotta love it.
She,
yeah.
I wanted to know where Jerry Springer's cameras were during all this event.
I'm telling you, his road crew was there someplace.
That. Hell, I was went on 10th most, I was on the 10th most wanted list, and I went, had a chance to go on Jerry Springer's show. You want to hear a little more? I wanted the federal protection too, don't you want to come on down, come on up here and start something? Oh, y'all being monitored on the CB.
Oh, Jerry Springer said?
Jerry Springer invited me on the show 3 times, man. I ain't bullshitting either. Me and her. They want to see what's going on. Oh, we were on a couple more of them, we were invited on a couple more of them talk shows too, but I wouldn't go. I was sitting in jail.
Man, you know what? If nothing else, Sam Flea, you damn sure didn't have a boring life.
The hell didn't. I still ain't got one. You ever see the women come and see me? I just sit and look. I had one come see me twice today. them?
I don't know if I want to see them kind of women.
Come up here and lick the milk. She's looking for a nice old man. She needs...
looking for money.
She's only 50. Drawing about $1,000 a month Social Security check, $900 a month food stamps, and she ain't got no kids, and she lives by herself. I wonder how she getting all of that.
Well, now, she figured out that you was a millionaire.
I'm a millionaire. No bullshit.
Well, she done figured this out.
I'm almost a millionaire when I divorced my old lady. When we got her divorced, I'll say it that way.
Huh, did you get all your millions from her?
That money again. She wouldn't spend it. She spent, she took 300,000 bucks and lost it in 30 minutes time. 300,000 and lost it in 30 minutes. What do you think about that? That's one stupid ass woman, ain't
it? I think, damn it, I wish I'd have met her back when she had all your money.
Well, everybody loved her. They dumped her ass up when she got rid of me and she didn't have no more money. They had to pay the bills. Up down in town, hey, you want me or I'll send her down there, man. Look at her, new sucker. You'd be just about right. That's an old married man. She likes to run around behind the wife's back. The one she was messing around with was the boss man down there at the post office. She found, I told her, I said, he's married. She said, no, he ain't. He ain't married. I thought he better not be married. Well, he was married. She married his wife and his daughter. And then she tried to kill his ass. What do you think about that? The FBI come and got her ass. What do you think about that one?
I think you gotta write a novel about that one.
They offered $10,000 a year. $10,000 a year and 2.5% royalty off the books talking about her tricks. And that ain't bullshit neither. They did change my name to something else. What the hell is done changing? What you talking to? They call me Loco or Sam Flea. Which one you want? I better shut up about being so late. She might drive up. I better go get me another beer. This is my fifth one today, so I better get me an extra one.
Alright, get another one.
So it's 5 o'clock, it's break hour, and I'll let y'all go to it, boys. Y'all have a good afternoon. I tell you a bunch of shit, bud. And it's all true, too. Ain't no damn lies. You'll meet my psychiatrist. Woo, she's good looking. Her name's Mrs. Bush. Mrs. Bush. And boy, she is sweet. Woo, doggy. She wants to date me, too, but I told her I couldn't date my psychiatrist. She'd find out too much about me. See y'all later. No cocker either.
Mrs. Bush, is that... Well, geez, I better keep it clean.
She's clean to that bush, at Bush's.
Her bush is clean?
Well, the bush is clean, you know, the president and all of them.
Oh, I thought maybe she was trimming her bush or something.
I love to trim her bushes, but you know how it is. I can't date my psychiatrist. That's against federal law.
Oh, she's a psychiatrist.
What do you think I said? A nut?
Well, I thought that you were playing with her bush or something.
Oh. Hold your neck.
All right, 10-4. You know, I get easily confused, Sam Fleek. Go get another beer and come right back.
Well, I do step right over that ice chest cooler. Boy, I got a full of ice and beer. Ooh, I ain't had no guys by today, so I got some extra beer left. All the bombs ain't showed up yet.
10-4, well... No guys, and you've had some girls, you're doing pretty good.
Sure, the women, them old guys, they don't feel just right. Just bullshit.
.151, what do you think about the situation?
I'm speechless.
Oh, that's a terrible situation.
Just so flabbergasted.
Now, you should be happy to be amongst a gentleman that has had quite a life that he's had, you know. It's, we can only dream.
75 years of excellence.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I used to go over Notre Dame up in the South Bend.
No, I didn't.
And you stomped the shit out of them old football players, too, after the game was over. That's no bullshit either.
You used to stomp the shit out of the Notre Dame guys?
Huh? Three of us. We called ourselves the Saints.
Boy.
Edge kid, when he come down through town there in the car, he's hollering, yeah, we won, we won. And they start cussing at us, because our team lost. We just stomped the dog shit out of them. Beat the windows out of the car. No damn bullshit either.
Holy crap.
We're back in the 60s.
Yeah, I wasn't around then, but I mean, I was at the tail end of it. I mean, the tail end.
I had a good reputation up there. A good one. They asked me to leave town and go to jail, so I left town. Three brothers, they stayed in town. They stayed that winter. When they come out. When I went back the next summer, they were all sitting in jail for about a year to five. They got caught.
10-4, sounds like you're the smart one of the bunch.
I had my choice either leave or go to jail with them, so I left. They told me up front, told us all, if y'all want to leave, we just drop a second. You off there, and you get out there and do it again, you go to jail. We all, my dad and mom come to Florida, and I did too. I didn't stay.
That sounds pretty smart to me. You've done the same there, 151, right? Get out of New Orleans.
What was that?
I said you would have done the same. Get the hell out of Dodge.
Yeah, that'd be the smart thing to do.
You have a little space from him out there, aren't you? Just terrified.
I was devastated.
They asked me to leave Hillsboro. That's where you know we're in Polk County.
You done scared the hell out of all of us down here, Sunfleet.
I'll never be the same again. That's gospel.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Brady.
On the bookkeeper, too, back in the late 50s and 60s.
You're a what keeper?
We're Al Capone's bookkeeper. Al Capone's bookkeeper, Michigan.
410.
And he worked for him for 15 years.
Just one of the boys.
They got Herb Porter coming into my Indiana radio. Buckwild in the cornfields, reading the mail.
You get been in them cornfields reading that mail, old Sam, please waving right back. See me to that fresh corn before it freezes.
And figure in the cornfield.
Not allowed.
Oh. That child abuser in there.
Who's a child abuser?
I believe my radio said that.
Well, don't worry, Sampler. I won't slap you around.
You might think that's new, sir. Hey, your company gone yet?
Who's the Sam? Is Sampler the child abuser, is he?
Yep.
I watch the talking on the CB, man. Everybody listens.
you just kind of whip them anyway, wouldn't you?
Take his radio away from him.
Please buy me a new one. Buy me a bigger striker.
I'll take that one, too.
All right, Sheriff Bump said they want you to come all over here and walk in the yard. They're going to take you.
I ain't going to go over there. I'll just take your radio from here, dumbass.
you can't take it. Hey. You can't take it. You got to sit back and listen. I told you I'm going to buy me a new one. Bitch and grown again.
Wah!
You been doing all right, bud? home to me a little bit. You been doing all right? I've been doing wonderful.
Every one of them every time you fire up. So you on that illegal radio?
Sure is. Hey, y'all better watch this track of radio now, they illegal. Man, better these track of radio is they talk too much, they talk too good. Want them men to be illegal. One or two dead men are gonna blast their ass off standing right here. About 4 or 5 months ago, they laughed their ass off.
That's because they didn't read part 95, subpart D.
They were standing there laughing. You had your gator going on, you had your mouth just running on the radio. I said, that's him right there. Where did he live? I said, Babson Park. You kidding me? No damn wonder he's so loud. I said, you cuss? He said, that dude doesn't make anybody cuss listening at him. That right in my house when they said it too, bud.
Well, why they didn't haul you off?
Well, they'll haul your ass off, but they got a call to go somewhere else.
You gonna go after a real criminal?
Didn't tell them what street you live on now. I kept my mouth shut on that one. For the dog bark. You're getting rid of them dogs today.
You think you know something, but you got it all screwed up.
Oh, you said you're getting rid of them dogs.
Yeah, when you're gone, you're gone.
No, when they're gone, they're gone. Hell, mine comes back every time she goes off. If they're gone a couple days, she's right back.
Is that the ex-wife?
Catching them fleas, she just can't stay away from no sand fleas.
Is that the ex-wife you're talking about?
I'm talking about a damn dog.
10-4.
10-12. We're in breaker for the sand pile.
Rust ain't breathing hard.
Somebody out there calling for the sand pile.
Yeah, they were hollering when I go.
Oh, I'm not ghost talking.
No, they were hollering when I go. I went back to them. The Mustang came in there. So anyhow, they're out there hollering. Hey, they can hear us. They say they can hear us all over down here. I was doing that in there, boys. I'm going to take a break. Y'all go get it.
We're gonna go get you, but they only realize you done cost the taxpayers enough damn money.
Ouch.
They said just let the people feel with that one.
Silence.
They always said honesty's the best policy. Tell it like it is.
What the judge said, he ain't gonna pay, he ain't never gonna pay, but it's costing the taxpayers money.
Hey, 164.
Yeah.
Antenna's ETA is the 22nd.